Hi, children. Good morning, everyone. So let us start with a new chapter today. And I'm back with class 10 mathematics. Today we will discuss chapter number 10, which is circles. And this is video number 1 related with chapter number 1. So related with circles, there are certain terms which you already studied in class 9. So as always, I start with the recall section. And then we'll go to certain things that we need to learn and new. So the first thing is about lines in a circle. Lines in a circle. So there are few lines in a circle. The first one is a radius, which you know is the distance from the center to the circumference. Center to the distance between the center to the circumference. This is the radius. And this radius is at equal distance from every point on the circumference. So this is at equal distance from every point on the circumference. So this is the radius. Now I think so by now everybody knows what is the radius. Then the second one is, you can see here it is diameter. So you know what is a diameter. Diameter is double of radius. And a line whose endpoints lie on the circle and it passes through the center. A line that passes through the center and whose endpoints lie at the circumference is called a diameter. Chord is any line drawn to the circle. Any line inside the circle which whose endpoints lie at the circumference of the circle. So that is a chord. A chord is a line segment which lies inside the circle and whose endpoints lie on the circumference of the circle. And then that diameter is called the longest chord of the circle because it passes through the center and has the longest length. Then arc of a circle is part of the circumference, that is an arc. Segment is the area between an arc and a chord. Area between an arc, this arc and a chord, any chord. This is the segment. Then sector. It is the area between two radius and an arc. This is the center. This is arc, minor arc AB. So this is area of minor sector. If I take APB, that will be the major sector. So there are two sectors in a circle. One is major, another is minor. Similarly, there are two segments in a circle. One is minor. The part of the area that contains the center is called the major segment, and then consequently the other one is the minor segment. Then third, sixth sector, then seventh is secant. Secant is a line which passes through the center, which passes through the circle, which intersects the circle at two different points, say P and Q. Now, a secant can be of two different types. One which would completely intersect the circle and cross it. The other might be one which intersects the circle at two different points but may not cross it further. So that is, there are two different types of secants. Now, the most important one which we have got to use in this particular chapter is the line which is tangent. All these things were just recall. Something which we have got to use it here in this chapter very frequently is tangent. Now, tangent is a line which touches the circle at exactly one point. Tangent is a line which touches the circle only at one point or exactly at one point. Now, if this is any point, then a line which touches the circle at only one point is called the tangent of a circle. Now, tangents, there are so many other things that we talk about tangent. That is, there can be infinite tangents drawn on any circle. There can be infinite tangents drawn on any circle. So, like this is P, Q, R, S, T, and similarly. As you know that a circle is made of infinite points, so at every point one tangent is possible. So infinite tangents is possible on the circumference of a circle. Through one point, only one tangent possible. There can be many tangents through all different points, but through one point, only one tangent is possible. And where we draw the tangent, this point where the tangent is drawn is called the point of contact. This is called the point of contact. Then from an exterior point, from any exterior point, that is the point which lies outside the circle, only two tangents can be possible. One and two. Two tangents from an exterior point. Two tangents from exterior point. Only two tangents can be drawn to any given circle from one exterior point. Then parallel tangents, parallel to the diameter. There is a diameter. If AOB is a diameter, then there can be only one pair of tangent, one pair of tangents which are parallel to the diameter. We can draw infinite parallel lines to the diameter. You can draw so many parallel lines to the diameter. This is the diameter. This line can be parallel. This can be parallel. This can be parallel. There can be so many parallel lines through the diameter. Parallel lines to the diameter. But only one pair of parallel tangent. One pair of parallel tangents possible to the diameter. To one diameter, of course. To a diameter, there is only one pair of parallel tangents possible. So these are certain things that is related with lines in a circle. And then now we, once I clean this board, then I'll return with that theorems. Those are related with these tangents and related theorems related with the circle. So this done with, then let me return with the theorems. Alright, so this is the first theorem that we have related with circles. So the theorem reads that the radius of a circle is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. That means this is the theorem. You have to prove it. That the radius of a circle is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact, say P. So as usual, you know that whenever we start proving a theorem, we start with given, then we come to proof, then construction, figure and proof. So these are the five major parts of a proof. So now coming to what is given. Given is a circle COR. By now you know what is the representation means. C means circle. O means the center is O. R means the radius of the circle is denoted by small r. So we are given a circle COR and a tangent AB touching the circle at P. That means P is the point of contact. Now, now you see this figure. This is a circle with center O. Point of contact of the tangent P, AB is the tangent. Now what is to prove? OP is perpendicular to AB. OP is perpendicular to AB. This is what we have got to prove. Now what are the construction required? So construction required is, we are taking two points Q and R on either side of P at the tangent AB. This is the tangent AB, this is point P, and you can see one point is on the left of P and another point is on the right of P. Q and R, we have taken two different points. Now what is the concept we are using here? The concept that we are using here is to show that from an exterior point, from an external point, from a point that lies outside any line, perpendicular is the shortest distance between any point and a line. And we remember this theorem that a perpendicular is the shortest distance between a point and a line, and the point not lying on the line. That means the point lies outside the line. So if there is a line like this, there is any other point outside, and the perpendicular distance will always be the shortest distance between any line. If you take anything other than that on that point, you can clearly see that these points will be greater than this, taking into account the right angle to triangle this concept. This is class 9 portion. I hope you understand. So this is, that is the concept we are using here, that perpendicular is the shortest distance between a point and a line. So if we have to use that concept, if we have to show that OP is the shortest distance, so that means we have to have more points to show that OP is the shortest one. So to verify that OP is the shortest distance, or OP is the, P is that point which is the shortest between O and P. So then we have to take two more points, that is Q and R, to verify that P is nearest to O. So we have taken two more points on the same tangent away from P and R, P, away from P. One is on Q, one is Q, other is R. Now let us join OP, OQ and OR. So take two points Q and R on either side of P at the tangent AB. And then what more we have to do? Join OP, OQ and OR. This also is part of the construction. Join OP, OQ and OR. Now, we can clearly see that this OQ intersects the circle at Q0. OR intersects the circle at R0. So now we come to, we mark those points, point of intersection, and then we come to the proving part. So now from the figure, something which you can observe is OP is equal to R, that is the radius of the circle. OQ is equal to R plus Q0 O. I mark this point as Q0 R0. So OQ is equal to R plus Q0 Q, this segment. OR is equal to R plus R0R. There is another segment. So what does this clearly implies then? That OP is smaller than OQ, or for that matter, OQ is greater than OP. This is from 1 and 2. From 1 and 2. And then second we have is OR is also greater than OP from 2 and 3. From 1 and 3, because these are all greater than, there is a segment which is more than R. So these two lines are greater than OP. So from this we conclude that OP is the shortest distance from O to AB. So from these two results, we will conclude that OP is the shortest distance from O to AB. So that implies OP is perpendicular to AB. Now where is the reason? Reason is here. So as we know that the shortest distance between a point and a line is a perpendicular distance. So either you can write this reason first and then you can put it up over here, your conclusion. Or else you can write down the conclusion, but then you have to mention the reason. This is one part which carries a whole lot of marks. Because this, as always, you know that the theorem comes for 4 marks. And by now you know that given to prove construction and figure, this comprises of 2 marks. So what are the steps? Now this half of the mark will be there also for this reason. Half for 3 conclusions. This together, because sometimes you will see that in some of the books only one point is taken. So these are the 2 equations which is important, and these 2 equations are again important. So this, for these 2 you get half marks, for this 2 you get half marks. So this and these 2 together gives you 1 mark. The result will give you half mark, and this reasoning will give another half a mark. So that is how the 4 mark is distributed. So this is theorem number 1. I'll return with theorem number 2, and then we will do the questions all together in the next video. So for the time being, up to video number 1 we do this, then video number 2 second theorem, and then the questions that would follow. Okay, so till then, thank you for watching. Alright, so let us quickly see 2 questions based on theorem number 1, and then we will go to theorem number 2. So the first type of question that you get is, a tangent PQ at a point P of a circle of radius 5 cm meets a line through the center O at a point Q such that PQ is equal to 12 cm. Find the length of OQ. Now again, I repeat the question. It says a tangent PQ. So PQ is a tangent. at a point P. P is the point of contact of a circle of radius 5 cm. So OP is 5 cm and meets a line through the center O. Meets a line through the center O. There is a line drawn through the center O. So this tangent meets a line drawn through the center O at a point Q. This tangent P meets a line drawn through the center at some point, say Q, such that PQ is 12 cm and the radius of the circle is 5 cm. Now we have to find the length of OQ. So because we know that the radius is perpendicular to the point of contact of the tangent, so we know OP will be perpendicular to PQ, and then OPQ will be a right triangle formed where OQ, line OQ will be the hypotenuse, OP is the perpendicular, PQ is the base. So what do we get? Using Pythagoras theorem, OQ square is equal to OP square plus PQ square. By now this should be very clear. And now we are given OP and we are given PQ. We substitute it and then we get it 5 square plus 12 square. Simplify, the solution you get is 169. So you get OQ square equal to 169. OQ is square root of 169, which is 13 cm. So now we have got the length of OQ, which is x equal to 13 cm. So this is one type of question. The second one, here you are given the radius, and the second question you will be asked to find the radius, any one of these three lines. So most of the questions are going to be the same type. So I have just taken up two for this, and then if there is any difference here, we can always discuss. Now coming to question number two is, find the radius of a circle if the length of the tangent from a point at distance of 25 cm from the center of the circle is 24 cm. Find the radius of a circle, first thing. So we have OA, if the length of the tangent from a point, length of the tangent from a point, say A, at distance of 25 cm from the center of the circle is 24 cm. So from the center of the circle, wherever it meets, wherever the tangent, this line from the center meets the tangent, that point is at 24 cm from the point A. So if the length of the tangent from a point at distance of 25 cm from the center of the circle. So if from the center of a circle, the distance is 25 cm. At that point, the length of the tangent is 24 cm. This is the meaning. Now you have to find the radius of the circle. Again, the same story what we did. So we got to find the radius of the circle. So we know what OA is perpendicular to AB. So we are again using that Pythagoras theorem, in right triangle OAB, hypotenuse square minus base square equal to perpendicular square. So OA square equal to OB square minus AB square, that is equal to 25 square minus 24 square. So 25 square is 625, 24 square is 576, subtract, you get 49. So you get OA square equal to 49, therefore OA is equal to 7 cm. So these are the only probable type of questions that you have related with theorem number 1. So in next video, I'll return with theorem number 2 and the questions related with that. So till then, thank you.